Time had a lot going on in my life, my brothers and Arjun, my family, and my mum and dad's been up. And I remember I went for a run. I wanted to go for a run, it came in the rain. What was going on? I went for a run. And when I was running, I was thinking about what was going on. I was only 12 at the time. And when I was running, all I can remember, when I was running, I woke up in the hospital. And I was run over by a van from 50 miles out. I broke me two ankles. I was in a bad way. I was in intensive care. And thank God I woke up later and I was alright. And I had off operation. And we left ankle. My two ankles broke, but I had off operation, we left ankle. I went down for an operation, everything went well, thank God, and come out and I was alright. And about 2 weeks after that, I had to go to Royal Northern Masters in the sun. And at the time, I didn't know what was going on, but when I went the first time, we got to the lawyer there and scanned and things, but at the time, I didn't know what was going on. And then, I think it was 2 or 3 days later, I had to go back again. And they told me I had cancer, I had a tumour, it was called, I had cancer. And my family was crying or whatever, and I thought something was right. Because I had a cancer. And I had a biopsy, and obviously the second time, when they wanted to scan me again, so one doctor, a third doctor said, let's scan her again, let's make sure. And the second time when that, they told me I had been scanned, and that night I come back and I had your fear. I couldn't believe it. And the Lord has healed me. What I want to give him the glory for. The Jesus is what he's done. And he'll be from cancer. And about 2 years ago now, I was in the mug with my dad. And my granddad rung my dad and he said, because my granddad he had lung cancer. And he said, I've only got to give him a couple of days to live. I mean, this is my grandmother, who had lung cancer, and my granddad was going down. I said, yes, I'll come down with you and start with me and my whatever. So I went with my dad, and I remember on the way, I put a Christian song out called, it was Do You Love Me, Bob Bond, and I was listening to it, or whatever. I've always believed in God, I just thought I'm young, I was giving life to the Lord in a moment. And I was listening to the song, and I started crying. I thought to myself, what am I going to do? This is something to do, do you love me? What am I going to do? And I knew the Lord was speaking to me. And as the time was going on, I was always thinking about God. And I've always thought I had to go to church to give me life to the Lord. And go up for prayer and give me life to the Lord about the prayer. And my grandmother was a Christian, and I remember he always used to be. He was scared of dying, but and one of the nights he said, I spoke to the Lord and he said, everything's going to be right, so I'm going to give him now. And obviously, that was peace of mind. And he encouraged me. And then at the time, I was always thinking about God. You know, I want to give you life to the Lord. And he said, I've got to go to church to give you life to God. So I don't know if you give life to the Lord. And my granddad passed away shortly after that. And a couple of weeks after that, I'd always think about God and always listen to Christian music. And I'd sit and cry all the time, and I remember saying to my dad, I said, Dad, I said, I keep thinking about God, I said, grandfather. And he said, pray about it. So I did a prayer about it, and prayed about it, whatever. And a couple of days afterwards, I was saying to my granddad's, down there to my granddad's, and I got someone who tell me all the time, about Jesus, and at the end, someone was preaching, and telling you everything to say, then give your life to Jesus. And I had to, accept the Lord into your life. And I was listening to him, and he encouraged me, and I had tears in class. And anyway, I was thinking about all day, and then I was sat on the set here, and I listened to it again. And all of a sudden, I started praying to the Lord. I lifted my hands in the air, and I said, Lord, so please come into my life. I said, change my life. I said, I need you now. I said, come into my life. So I accept you as my Lord, your personal Lord and Savior. I said, come into my life. And since the 7 words, I knew I was safe. You come into my life. Amen. There's nothing like being saved. I'm telling you, anyone in here who don't know the Lord, who's not a Christian or did not know the best thing I've ever done is be best in the world. And I'll come up with encouragement and give me testimony.